What do you do when you have several digestive conditions and they're getting worse? Right? Good question. Huh? What do you do? Okay? Do you take more medications? What do you think?
No.
Increase the number of pills? No. Do more surgeries?
Mm-mm.
All right. I had a patient of mine had done 23 surgeries. True story. I'm telling you about clinical cases. These are not stories that we're making up. Patients I see every day. 23 surgeries. Think about it, ladies and gentlemen. It's horrible. 23 invasive incisions in the body. What do you do? Take more supplements? One day I'm going to show you the pictures I took in my facility about the number and the amount of supplements or supplement containers that people bring me. 30, 40, 50. You take more painkillers? Had a patient come the other day, she's taking 8 painkillers. None of them is working. 8. Do more injections? How many of you and how many of your friends and family you've heard they did the cortisone injections? Or pain blockers, or none of those, okay? And then after a while, I had a patient come to me 3 months ago, told me, Jaudy, she had horrible, severe neck pain. And her neck looks like scary, okay? She said, injections are not working anymore. And she's in pain 11 out of 10, not 10, 11. Excruciating, okay? Or just live in pain and misery. So what do you do? Which one of these is an option? What do you think?
No.
Anyone is an option?
No.
Who would choose one of those?
No.
None. Right answer. Okay? Great answer. This is very, very important. We're going to look now, you and I and the world, about the neurological connections of the digestive system to the brain. This is crucial, and it's a breakthrough in understanding. Okay? So, this is the digestive tract, huh? For those who are not familiar, you start eating and then things start firing instantaneously. Liver, stomach, pancreas, large intestine, small intestine, gallbladder. So if we put these together, this is healthy, this is diseased. Healthy, diseased. All right? So you don't want to be in this stage. Some of you say, well, okay, you know, Dr. Jaudy, there's nothing wrong with me. I feel good. How do you know how good you feel? Things erupt all of a sudden, huh? How many people that you know of, friends, beloved, family, whatever it is, they sleep, they never wake up? Or you've heard of? How many people have liver diseases, they never drink alcohol? How many people have lung cancer, they don't smoke? How many people, they drink tons of water, they have kidney failure? We hear this all the time, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so there is a problem, obviously. There is a disconnection problem between the organ and the brain. And the organ is not firing, so we're going to tell you what that is. Okay, this is important. Please focus on that. Give me all your attention. Ready? Okay, a chain of command. We humans are majestically wired with a chain of command. A chain of command is this, for this purpose. The first nerve cell in the chain, which carries the commands of central processing centers, is located within the brain. The first synapse, boom, I'm firing, it's in the brain, or the spinal cord, which is an extension. We're going to show you this. This cell passes the instructions via a synapse. Synapse is a conduction, it's an electric charge, okay? Which is an electrical or chemical signal to another nerve cell. Isn't that wonderful?
Mm.
And I'm so passionate about this. This first nerve cell that carries these signals is called preganglionic, which means it lives before it synapses on a booster station. Beautiful stuff, okay? Now, the second nerve cell, which lives in the organs, is called postganglionic. So, before the signal gets to your organ, it goes through a chain of command. Organs don't function on their own. Well, Dr. Jaudy, what has my liver got to do with my brain? All right, what has your brain got to do with you living? So something like that. Okay, so you're going to be very, very careful with this stuff, okay? So we're going to focus on two words, preganglionic, postganglionic. when it leaves the brain to the organ, from the organ to the brain, okay? So, this is your autonomic nervous system. What does that mean? Autonomic nervous system, this means your autopilot, okay? This is the system that when you eat now, you don't want to tell your liver, hey liver, what's going on down there? Digest for me. Hey stomach, do this. I want you to digest the turkey sandwich and leave the vegetables till 6 o'clock in the evening. You can't do that. You eat and this guy is on. It's an autopilot. If there is any dysfunction in this autonomic nervous system, welcome to the world of digestive disorders. Everybody understand that?
Yeah.
Who doesn't? Okay, good. We're going to make it simple. These are wires. This is the brain, not the brain, it's part of the brain, brain stem, spinal cord, and it's wired to the organ. So, organ gives a signal to the brain, brain gives a signal to the organ. Let's take a look at the liver. So, the synapse leaves here, goes all the way down, and from the liver goes all the way up, and the liver says, hey brain, I need more biochemical reactions. Can you help me? Brain says, okay, I'm on the wave, okay? It fires down. If that connection is lost, liver is congested. The world needs to understand this. Functionally, it's not that you go do a liver cleanse. If you do a liver cleanse and this guy is not getting the connection, what have you done? You have cleansed a dysfunctional organ. You need to understand this. It's important. Because I had a patient. They told him, okay, you need to clean your liver. So they put him on lemon juice and oil and I don't know what, and salt and all this stuff, okay? The guy did a liver cleanse and he erupted in liver patches. Misfiring. Okay, what's happening here? A preganglionic failure. Remember these two words? Preganglionic, postganglionic. A preganglionic failure occurs when the impulse generated fails to leave the brain to reach the organ. That is important. Profound. Preganglionic. My brain is not firing to my organ. It's not firing to that booster station, and the booster station is not able to read the signal. A postganglionic failure occurs when the impulse fails to arrive at the brain from the organ. So there is a two-way street. Complex stuff, isn't it? But beautiful. If it's working right, you enjoy life. Okay. Welcome back after the break. And prior to the break, we wanted to touch base on a very, very important slide, which is called visceral referral pain. Visceral means organs. Referral means it goes to a different site. Pain is pain. Everybody's familiar with pain, huh? Okay, so some patients come, or most people, or maybe you, some people among you, say, well, Dr. Jaudy, I hurt here, I hurt there, and she says, just pain here, all this area hurts. I have seen doctors, I've done injections, I've done, deep tissue, really, whatever it is, all this, you know, they just dug into me and I'm getting worse. What's going on? Listen to this. Not all pains are joint pains or muscle pains. Some pains could be coming from your organs. But you don't feel it in your organ because your organ cannot tell you, I ache. Because there is no pain perception or connection between your organ and your brain. But your organ refers pain to different sites. Could be here, could be there, could be knee, could be sinuses. How many people have sinus congestions? Did you know that if you, this is important, listen to this. Did you know that if your lymphatic system, you know, the lymph that drains your toxins, okay? Or if your liver is clogged or you have decreased circulation, you are toxic here. Sinuses. How many thousands and thousands of people a year, they do sinus surgery? That guy I'm telling you about, 65 symptoms, all started with a sinus surgery. Heart, okay? Now, maybe most of you know, maybe some of you know, that the heart refers pain to the shoulder, here, and to here, right? And that's how people know, like, what's going on? I'm dying. Okay, it could be the heart, could be something else. but we never know. But they could refer, could be the shoulder. But we don't know before we test and do an examination. Now, we're not going to talk about each one of those, but let's take the most common. Kidneys, for example. How many people or some people among you, they say, well, Dr. Jaudy, I have pain here. It's not going away. I did injections, I took medications, I did, they just did whatever they did, myofascial release, and they went into my abdomen, and the pain is there. It is coming, maybe, from your organs. We need to check the connections, the wiring system. Is that making sense to you guys? Very good, okay?